You wouldn't pay twice for your groceries or for a new shirt at the mall, but if you're a victim of robbery or burglary, you will probably have to pay to get your stuff back.
Property crimes are happening by the thousands in Southwest Florida, and as NBC2 investigator Delia D'Amber discovered, finding those stolen items is only half the battle.
There are dozens of pawn shops in Lee County, and none of them want stolen goods coming through their doors. But the inevitable can happen, leaving you as the victim fronting the cost.
Law enforcement officers in Southwest Florida see it thousands of times a year. People left with nothing after a thief makes off with their belongings.
We never expected that.
Nelson Struck lost more than just the belongings in his car or wallet.
The mother-in-law's jewelry.
The woman who stole priceless family heirlooms from Struck's family in Cape Coral pawned the jewelry across stores in Southwest Florida.
It was about $111,000 worth in total.
Struck believes it's easy for thieves to make quick turnaround cash on stuff they steal because of pawn shops.
They have no liability, but they have the ability to make all of the profit from it.
Sometimes won't take their stuff.
Midtown Golden pawn owner Robert Susie is not one of the shops that bought the Struck family stolen items, but he says pawn shops aren't the bad guys.
I don't want anything that's not legal to happen in my store.
Susie explains he can't interrogate a seller for no reason, but exercises caution.
In America, everybody is presumed innocent until proven guilty. So I'm not here to judge people, but you can get clues on if I think something isn't right.
Struck is frustrated there are little to no options for victims to get their stuff back without paying a price.
We had to pay the $500, even though it was ours. You have to pay for your own things.
By Florida law, victims can either buy their items back, try and convince a pawn shop to join them as a complainant, or wait until their case goes to trial and hope the defendant pays restitution. A state-issued form all pawn shops require customers fill out protects the shop from being labeled an active participant in laundering.
The system protects them. That's wrong.
The last time a legislator in Florida called for reform for pawn brokering was in 1998 after the assassination of fashion designer Gianni Versace. Andrew Cunanan may have been caught days before Versace's murder if the store had reported Cunanan for pawning stolen coins. That bill died. 2 decades later, Susie says he has to abide by current law and will help law enforcement whenever he catches a trickster trying to make a transaction.
So you try to really make sure that doesn't happen.
For the NBC2 investigators, I'm Delia D'Ambra.